11 days of water polo. A full-on schedule has reached its finale for the women's teams in Naples. All sides faced four pool matches, then playoffs, and now the best of the teams meet for the gold medal. Yes, it's Italy against Hungary for the gold and silver medals. The last match of many which have been played here at Piscine Scandone in Naples. The Hungarian team just being introduced to the crowd now, and no doubt they're getting a lot of fine reception, polite applause really, but when it comes to the Italians, I think the roof will be just about lifted off. So this team from Hungary, which has got some really stunning players. There you go. The roof has stayed on, but only just. The Italians have Chiara Rinaldi, who scored 16 goals. Also in the team, Sara Centani and Agnese Cocchiere with 12 and 14 goals. Big scorers for this powerful team. Cocchiere. And we'll have the FISU anthem in a moment. We'll be introduced to the officials as well. What a great atmosphere here for this final. Nice to see most of the players very relaxed, grinning and chatting with each other beforehand. They've done their warm-ups, they've played their games. They know they've done as much as they can to prepare for this particular match. This is where they wanted to be, these two teams, Hungary and Italy. They wanted to meet in this final. They wanted to be there, probably didn't matter who they played against. And there's no doubt that the two of them have thoroughly earned their way in. Hungary silver medalist 2 years ago. Martina Michelli, wonderful player herself, many years an Italian representative, and now a fantastic coach. That's the lineup for Italy. There. Big goal scorer Rinaldi, number five. Attila Mihuk. He's got six from the university he coaches at in this team. 13 goals apiece for Kovesdi, number six. Garda, number eight. Matta, number 12. Captain by Kovesdi. The statistics, the team list, tell me that there are five players in this Hungarian team over 6 foot or over. Does that give them any sort of edge? Well, what from seeing from Italy, I don't think so. It's all about skill, teamwork, timing, determination, accuracy. the huddle, before the dive, before the keeper and the six players from each team get in the pool. It's liftoff time. Italy wearing white. Sometimes that's all you can see, is just the cap. Eight minutes per quarter. The ball in the middle, at the center. That's where the sprint starts, from the end by the goal. They race out to get first touch on the ball. Sparano and Kish, they are the keepers. Sparano is the captain for Italy. For the Italians, Ranalli, their outstanding goal scorer, lines up in the center of the pool, goes early. It's game on. Gold medal match. Italy and Hungary in the women's water polo. First success, Italy. Ioannou. Centani out to the right. They played so well against Canada. I wonder if it was a tough enough test for them. Well, you don't get it much quicker than that. 18 seconds and Cocchiere scores center shot goal from the get-go. Bang, there you go. Stop that. No thanks, I can't. Hungary stung from the outset. Kovesdi. They're going to have to live with this crowd. Nata. Whoa, they're giving it to them. Kuna. Need to just shut the crowd out. A roar for every mistake. Ranalli, Kinchani. Oh, two! What? We haven't hit a minute yet. And Italy have hit two goals. A look-away pass. And Alessandra Kish had no show. Two in the net behind her. Hungary need to settle. Storo puts a big long arm up in front. Hungary looking for better position. Sparano, the captain, she leads by example. Ranalli, right hand into Centani. Kuzupe. Fintani again, almost finding the target. Turned the way into the team in blue. That's Hungary, who have not been in the match. Wow. So Italy have possession. Can't shoot from there, from where the original player had the ball. Tuzupe. Just watch what's going on away from the ball in front of goal. Look at the splash, and there's just a real battle going on between those two in attack and defense. The build up now, the crowd rises to it. Centane, clock down to 10. Off target this time. No wonder, when you look at a game like this, how tiring these players find it. It's been 11 days of competition, and lots of games have been like this, but not as much at stake as tonight. The Summer Universiade Waterpolo title is on the line here. Four seconds. Yeah, good shot. Hungary on the board at last through Hertzka. They timed it well, worked it right down to zero. High left-hand corner. It's quietened the crowd slightly. Now they'll lift, because their team, the Italian team, has possession. Centani finds Rinaldi out left. Center back there is Ioannou. Oh, under stress but safe. Alejandro Kish. The Hungarians, they topped Group A, and then to get through here, they beat Australia 7-4 and then Russia 16-14. The Italians top Group B and then beat Japan 12-8 and Canada 15-7. Sparano has the ball fed back to her. She in turn puts it to the right to Centani. Looking for a target in the center. Kuna saying, I had both hands and up. How could I have been fouling? Well, I'm sure we'll see some underwater shots. There were plenty of them in the break. We could get some great views of what was happening, some of the replays from the previous game. 2-1 Italy. One exclusion on Italy. Oh, but Hungary can't make any advantage of it. I don't take advantage at all. Back out on the right again. The familiar role of taking the ball up on the right. That's Kuzupe. Garda has 13 goals going into this game. She's number 8. Number 5 there is Hertzka. She's Garda. Garda again. Yep. Finger in the air. She's put in some great outside shots during this tournament. And we are now at 2-2 after a blistering start from Italy. 2 goals inside the first minute. She's powerful, Garda. Just up and winds up. A little over 2 minutes remaining in this first quarter. The gold medal women's water polo match. In the white caps, it's Italy. Hungary in the dark blue. Muksi. Here is Garda again. Will she load up and have another go? 12 seconds remaining. Looking for the lob, not accurate enough, and they backtrack instantly because Barano, the Italian captain and goalkeeper, will look to play the fast break by the Italian side, which they've done effectively throughout the tournament. By Garda. Kovesdi pops it in, looking for Garda. Kovesdi again. Brzozowski. That was Kovesdi, the captain from Hungary. Also going into this match, 11 field goals and 2 penalties. Cocchiere and Cintani from Italy have a slightly better record, but... Oh, there's a cute little lob. And Milo is delighted with that one. Just coaxed it over the goalkeeper. Watch this, just fainting, looking to fire it in, and then just lobbing it beautifully. Well judged. So it's now 3-2, been 2-2 for quite some time. 25 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Gold medal match. Hungary bringing the ball back up. Gemes, Garda. Ten seconds. Muksi. Garda again. Loads up and fires. Krisztina Garda. Again, top left hand We're tied up at 3-all. And that is the end of the first quarter. Well, it's been action-packed, this big match between Italy, the host nation, and Hungary. And it's tied up at 3-all. Coaches have had their say. The players have hopefully taken it on board. Martina Michelli, who played for Orizonte and went on to coach the team. She played from 1991 to 2008. Olympic gold medal in 2004 for Italy. Two world championship medals. Four European championship medals. Assistant coach Mauro De Paulis. We're back now with the people with the whistles who control this game. The line will be pulled at a moment and the floating ring will disappear. As who's leading out for Italy? Again, it's Ranalli, number five. Kuna. For the Russian Federation, wins that one. Well, a vital figure in the Hungarian lineup is that number eight. We've seen her, Krisztina Garda. There she is with the ball right now at centre back. Once again, well, that's a big outside shot from her. But hasn't she got the power to deliver? Sparana deflects it over the line, so corner throw for Hungary. Good deflection block from number 12, that's Cocchiere. De Claudio with the ball in the center. Cintani now. Got some great tactics, the Italians. Quite deceptive. There's Garda once more. She has out to her left a Gemez. Doesn't get that far. Sparano. with the ball under control, surveys the scene in front of her, delivers to Cintani. Hungary's defense now needs to be alert. Five seconds. Expulsion. So, man up, Italy. Can they make this count? No. They get the rebound. Players back in. Fully manned now. Six on six. Turnover. Hertzka. Oh, a dangerous play. The Italians were onto it. Just Kuna. We have a penalty here, do we? The crowd's not at all happy, as you can see. Oh. Who'd want to be a referee in this situation? 3-3. Penalty for Hungary. And up steps, or up swims, Garda. She's hoping she can hear, or she's watching for the arm to drop it. There it goes. Wham! Turns her fist almost to the crowd a little bit there. Krisztina Garda, an influential figure in this Hungarian team and in their chances of winning this gold medal. She departs though. Gets the goal. Moves. Yeah. Very happy. There she is. Off for a well-deserved break. Rotation works. Hungary know they have to silence the crowd if they can. They're up by 4-3. Second quarter. This might get quite fiery. They're not having the luck, the Italians. Let's see where this one went, off the bar. Gerendas. That was Kovesdi. Ioano. Italy desperately searching for an equalizer. Again off the bar. But Both these teams capable of the fast break. Kuna down the right hand side for Hungary. She takes it right up, tries the lob, just like the Italians, finding the bar. Man up again. The player up, of course. Ah, there it is. They take advantage. Deflection off the defenders. Yeah. Doesn't matter. Four all, 2.5 to go in the second quarter. Into the play again is Garda. She was sitting on the bench, almost begging to be brought back into play. She doesn't want to sit out this match. Deceptive shot from Ioannou. Carolina Ioannou. Dribbling it up for Hungary. Is their number 8. Timeout has been called. Garda just spins the ball on the finger. Fires the ball over to the side. It's a photographer, I think, waves and says, sorry about that. And then goes over to listen to what's being said. The 20-second advantage of one player up, Hungary. And skip bouncing, and they take advantage of it. 5-4. A minute 30 until halftime. Brzozowski. Whoa. An opportunity there for the home team to level up. They had the one player advantage. Kovesdi was out. Now back in. They're both fully manned. Garda watched by Ioannou. Storai. Trying to find Repetto. She might have been able to find her, except she was underwater. Boy, not sure how many times that is that the Italians have found the bar. Garda, big long throw as time runs down. 5-4 at half time. Hungary leading Italy in this playoff for the gold medal in the women's water polo. It's close at half time, just one goal in it. Interesting statistics there. Five steals down at the bottom for Italy. But just one from five extra play shots. One from five, the Hungarians have one from one. And so many of Italy's shots hit the bar. Four from 15 have gone in. Been some good saves too. Italy relying on Storai to get to the ball first. Mucci for Hungary, both the number 10s, and they're at it. Who gets there? Italy. Ioannou has control. Out on the right to Cintani. Oh, tries to find Gottardo, eventually does. Again, in exclusion. So they've got the numbers. Oh, almost. Who has possession? It goes the way of Hungary. Mate, who was excluded, she comes in now, takes the ball up on the left. Brzozowski. Whoa, that went nowhere apart from straight into the arm of Storai. Good block. Where's the ball? Way up to the right. Oh! Tentani. That rocks the crowd. The floor's shaking here. Five all. Mata finds the target. It was Hertzka. Back to Mata. Terendas. What? Bounce shot. Covered well. Centani. Italy, one player up. Exclusion on nine. Husti. Hungary get the rebound from the stop by Kish. Marcus takes it in a bit closer. Brzozowski. Way out to her right there is Karendis. She goes left. Climbing out of the water and taking that was Sparano. Five all. Italy in the white. Defending the right side of your screen. On attack now. Whoa. Another for the bar. Italy have it. It's Repetto. Rinaldi. Oh, it opens up for her. Whoa. The keepers are having a torrid time of it. Oh, we've got one player you might see down in front of the goal with no cap on it. Long hair is a great target, I'm sure. Just have a look at what's going on there. Where's the ball? I'm more engrossed in what some of the work that goes on off the ball. It's extraordinary, and it's a great part of water polo. Exclusion on number four, I think it was, Gerendes of Hungary. Timeout. That'll be called by Italy because they want to work out how they can look, there we are. Oh, she'll be pleased to get a cap on. So many of the, particularly the Italian team, have long hair. Back in. One player advantage for Italy. They've talked about how they can take advantage of this, and they all! Di Claudio. It was a great setup. Garda back in for Hungary. Eight seconds. Just finding the fingers of Gattardo. Eyes all anxiously looking towards the referee. Just see by the clock there, Martina Michelli screaming out instructions to her team. Not a good pass for Garda. Oh, there it is. It's been a long time coming, but we do have another goal in this match. 6-5, Hungary. Goal came at 6 minutes 13 in the third quarter. Where's Garda? There she is. Right in front of her is Gerendes. Back now to Brzozowski. She has it again. 9 seconds. She loads up, pumps. Keeper puts it to the line. Corner throw for Hungary. Taken by Durandes. Brzozowski. Gemez now. Big outside shot, but ineffective here from Garda. Now Italy. Oh, crowd roaring for a penalty. Have a look at that, ladies and gentlemen. That's big advantage of the underwater cameras, which they never used to see back in some of those horrendously tough matches of many years ago. Oh, penalty miss. Ranalli. 16 goals, top scorer going into this match. They didn't expect that, I don't think. The clock was counting down. Gemez, it didn't look to be have too much impact in it. But it does sneak by the keeper, Sparano. And the advantage is now two with 5 seconds or so till three-quarter time. There's the hooter. This is an intriguing and exciting, riveting match. So much action. Helped by this great crowd here at Piscine Scandone. And we go to three-quarter time at 7-5, Hungary leading. A tense time now for the Italians. Been giving so much support here by their hugely vocal crowd, which has really made the atmosphere here tonight. It's almost a sign of from the coach Michelli that just take it easy, calmly. There's plenty of time. There's 8 minutes remaining. You're down by two at 7-5. Ball's in the ring. Slowly back. Goes the keeper. These two keepers will be have been worked overtime. Just waiting for the signal. Are you ready? Kuna for Hungary. Obviously, a little bit of a disagreement going on here, and that is the one of the referees heading down the Hungarian coach. He's zipping up over the fence and he's up here taking a seat, so he's been expelled. Whoa, there's some feeling here, and isn't that great? Atula Mihok. So Martin Benzier now rules it down on the side. Well, I can, he's just walking only a few meters up from where our commentary position is. People are grinning, but he's not. Seven-5. Hungary leads. Well, will this affect Hungary or make them even more urgent? They don't get the sprint to the ball. Ioanu. Final quarter, gold medal match. Load up, bounce shot, that's in. Hertzka. The Claudio now at centre back, up to Centani. This is Ranali. Wow. Just as Hungary thought they had possession, the crowd thought it had gone the other way. It is still with Hungary. Kovesdi. Kuna. Both teams getting tired, needing to retain their skill and accuracy. Mate. Kuna again. Oh, again. It's the bar. It's rocked by Kovesdi. Storoy, centre back, looking, searching, might have given it away. No, De Claudio holds. Ranali, exclusion. on Mate. Well, the ball seems to be attracted to the post and the bar for the Italians. Remains at 8-5. Out left. Gemets, Husti. Well, steal by Italy. Ranalli. An exclusion on Husti. Well, this is an opportunity, and this will get Martina Micheli. Here she is now. Righto, here's our opportunity. We're going to haul one back. We've got 20 seconds of a one-person advantage. We're down by 3, 8-5. We need to get that. They need to score here. This is an opportunity. Yes, they do. In the hole was Cocchiere. Plenty of time remaining. That's a tired but retaining accuracy and skill. Cocchiere puts it away. Gap closes. 8-6. Centani had the assist on that. Good communication. The boos go up now. Not an Italian crowd giving it to the opposition, surely. Yes, they are. Gemes and Covesdi teaming up now with Brzozowski. Whoa. Blocked by Gottardo. Still with Hungary. Covesdi now out to the right. Gemes. Brzozowski again. Just those three using it. Oh, good work again. The bar. Ranalli. She plays the lob shot really well. Turnover or not? Yes, it is. The steal by Hungary. Cocchiere couldn't capitalize this time. Covesdi takes it up. Slowly. Brzozowski. Counter here from Italy. Ranalli takes it up, dribbles it up quickly. In the hole is Di Claudio. And also Cocchiere waiting. No. Number three, that is Fakas. Another chance here. Remember, they pulled it off brilliantly for the last time they had a player advantage. So Ranali starts it. A countdown from 20. Looking for the lob again, or not quite. Kazupe. Eight, six, 3 minutes to go. Hungary. Kuna. Kovesdi and Gemez. Brzozowski once more. 3 seconds, looking for the lob. Once more, the bar. Quick breakout. No. De Claudio holds. Milo. With Cocchiere right there in the center. Along with Gotardo. 10 seconds on the shot clock. 4 seconds. Hungary win that. Two minutes to go. Time running out for Italy. Now they really need to break quickly. Up the left-hand side comes Ranali. It goes to her. Into the center goes Gotardo. Ranali pops it back for De Claudio. Milo. Still in the center, Cocchiere. Pumps, fires. The crowd is up in unison. 8-7. It's game on. 8-7. No bar or post in the road this time. Hungary will take it right down to the zero. Oh, no, they don't. Still breakout chance for Italy. Cocchiere waits. Cocchiere can't get to it. What's the call? It's all fair. Hungary. Wide to Gerendis. Kuna. Attracts two defenders. Look at that big space in the middle. As Hungary just want to use up all their time. Italy looking for the foul and the turnover foul. Timeout called. So assistant coach Martin Benzier is talking. I could just got a glimpse of the coach Attila Mehuk, who's up the back and looking frustrated and annoyed. Oh, you can't see him, but I'll tell you what, well, you might know what he looks like. He is ready to explode up there. His team is holding an 8-7 lead and he's not there. Six on six, 15 seconds to go. They run it down. Up comes their goalkeeper, Sparano. She takes it up herself, dribbles it up. What happens here? She's going to take the shot. And Hungary, their players leap in the air for those not in the water. Those in the water punch the air. There is jubilation for this team from Hungary. Coaches in, caps are off. It's been a riveting game, such a close match. Hungary winning by 8-7, scoring 8 from 29. Italy 7 from 27, equal really in the number of shots. Extra player shots, 2 from 3 for Hungary, only 2 from 10 for Italy. 7 steals for Italy, 3 block shots each. Those are the statistics, but the one that really matters is the score. And it is Hungary who have beaten Italy 8-7 and are the Summer Universiade champions for 2019. A coach who was up the top of the stand, having been expelled from the pool. He's in the water now. And while the Italians may well and do feel dejected, they have had a very impressive tournament. The sign of victory and it's been a battle out there. That's not an underwater shot we need to see. They are absolutely overwhelmed with this. And for the Italian crowd, it's been a massive support effort from them. They're proud of their team. The gold medal is...